The ancient founder or metal worker reduced native ores from their natural forms, metal oxides, to a metallic state. In this state, they could be fashioned by hammering or molding into useful or decorative items. What the early metal worker did was fill a bowl-shaped depression in the ground with charcoal, his fuel, ignite the fuel, and when it was burning briskly place his native ore or metallic oxides on the fuel. Conditions of the supplied combustion can be controlled by the operator. The combustion was increased in intensity by supplying additional oxygen to the fuel. When metallic oxides are heated to a sufficient temperature in a zone where there is a deficiency of oxygen, the oxygen in the ore itself separates to help complete combustion, and this reduces the ore to an oxygen-free metallic state. Thank you.
The resulting metal drips down through the fuel to form a metallic slug or button, which, when cooled and solidified, is recovered and worked as desired. Ancient metal workers learned that an ore could only be reduced to a metallic state if it were melted in a zone where there was a deficiency of oxygen and a sufficiency of carbon. The reason for this is that the oxygen in the metal oxide carbon dioxide, a product of combustion. Should an ore that is a metallic oxide be raised to a high temperature in a zone containing excessive oxygen, it will not melt. If a metal in its pure state is melted or heated to a high temperature in a zone of combustion that contains excessive oxygen, it quickly oxidizes into a metallic oxide.